Welcome to the Collider Video movie review for Cats.
Cats.
I don't even know where to begin. I still don't know. How many nights are we removed from our screening? I still don't know if I could formulate a proper sentence about how I feel about this movie, especially when you compare it to how we usually talk about movies. This just feels like such a bizarre anomaly to me that I can't even wrap my mind around how to begin to assess it right now.
This is the thing about Cats. The movie Cats is exactly the musical Cats. Mm-hmm. If you have seen the musical Cats, the movie is really not that different.
There's Judi Dench cat.
It's just a bunch of cats introducing themselves. But that's the movie.
But Emma, though, is it though like the musical Cats? Because I think most of us have seen the musical
I've
Cats.
I've certainly seen it.
I actually got to see it as a child in Mexico City, and that was something wild. But this movie, I had Perry right next to me and Jim Veboda from IGN, and we could not stop laughing.
And
I felt so bad because slowly we're like, well, the publicists are there, but you were giving us drinks and you're treating us so well and you're so nice, but we can't not laugh.
Both of you have seen Cats.
Yes.
I know the popular songs. Mm-hmm. Like I know what memories, but I've never sat through the full story in my life.
It's not really a story.
This is really it.
In the play, it's more like the cats are singing to the audience about being cats. They're also less committed to being cats than the actors in this movie.
See, that's what I'm not quite understanding, because I watched this movie and the first thing I think I said to you, I think maybe even while the movie was going, is like, people should just not act like cats. But I also know that that show is beloved. It's one of, the longest running show in Broadway history or something like that.
It was for a while anyway.
I just can't take what I saw in this movie and make that compute. It makes no sense to me.
So Cats is an ensemble dance show. And the movie so there's this featured dance role in the play called McCavity. And Idris Elba's character. Okay. So when
I also can't remember the names for the life of me.
That's okay. I got them all.
Just say Jellicle a lot. Yeah. Jellicle.
What does Jellicle mean?
Nobody knows.
Only T.S. Eliot knows. So basically what they did, what Thomas Hooper and company did when they were making this movie was they looked at the play of Cats and they looked at this dance role of McCavity, who in the play is a bad cat.
Right.
But that's it. Like, he's just a bad cat. And they looked at him and they go, what if McCavity was the antagonist and we're going to make that movie? And that's what this movie is.
A lot of them are bad cats.
It is true that there are dancing cats, though, but it's the design of it. I feel like I was watching a video game that was really weird, or like the Cats musical version of a video game.
Yes.
But then while that was happening, because they looked so strange, I couldn't stop looking, but I was also terrified at the same time. It's kind of like my brain was being eaten by a parasite.
Yeah, a little uncanny valley.
But I was also happy, you know?
Yeah.
So yeah.
Yeah, I don't even know. Cause like the thing that I'm having a hard time with is I've got a lot of people asking me, oh, well, would you recommend it? And this isn't a good movie.
No, it's not.
The execution, it's like, one of the things I don't understand too is we're always talking about how many people are involved in making one feature film. How did no one put their foot down along the way and say, this isn't a good idea. We shouldn't execute the story on the big screen quite like this. But even though I don't think it's a good movie, I had quite a good deal of fun. And this feels especially mean, but it's the truth. We were sitting there that night, and it's almost like when you're in a theater packed full of people who, you know that feeling when you're trying to hold back a laugh,
but all of a
sudden someone near you giggles and there's no holding. That it was like that every 5 minutes, and kind of communal laughter has value.
Oh yes, and then it only grew as the movie went on, because the movie just kept getting more and more ridiculous. I mean, you had somebody like Jennifer Hudson, who is brilliant and just actually, the most like beautiful voice.
She's genuinely so good in this movie.
She is, but she looks so ridiculous,
she does.
And it is not her fault.
It never stops being distracting.
No,
I thought that there was a chance that at the very beginning, like, okay, once I get wrapped up in the story, I'll forget about this. No,
right.
Because she has a moment where she's belting out Memory and yep. I mean, emoting to the max. And then all of a sudden they cut to Judy Dench Cat. I'm never going to remember their names.
Old
Judy
Dench Cat.
Old that. Well and done. They cut to her and it was like the shot just stayed on her yep. like a hair too long.
Dude,
and everyone in the audience erupted.
Can we talk about that final song in the play?
Yes.
Where the camera is close on Judy Dench.
You are losing your mind.
But the poor cat who plays Victoria the White Cat and or the girl that
they're
plays
all
Victoria.
Just staring
and the guy
at her.
Who's Mr. Mistopheles, their faces are also both in frame, but they're like sort of out of focus and they're just acting so hard. And oh my God.
But it was so weird because she was like, Dame Judy Dench was staring at our souls.
Yes.
You know what I mean? And telling us, she's like, I am not a dog. I am a cat.
I know.
And I was like,
our whole,
cool,
the whole audience I was with.
It was incredible.
Out loud. Because at that point, it's the end of the movie. And we are right. all just like, I cannot believe
See,
this is happening.
See, but also that there's also other things that are amiss here.
Yeah.
Not just the fact that it's like, you know, a little bit of a weird execution, mm-hmm. putting these famous actors in this kind of getup with VFX and whatever costumes they were wearing on set. But it's also real true issues in the directing, the framing of that shot.
It's terrible.
It's strange. It's strange
also, okay,
to focus on a character.
But he's the director. What happened?
But we're
it's
also
so bizarre.
Talking about Thomas Hooper, who when he was working on Les Miserables,
right.
where you had this opportunity for this show that is about this resistance in Paris, and we could have seen the whole freaking city. Instead, he's like, you know what people want to see? Eddie Redmayne's terrible jaw tension. Let's shoot the entire movie up people's nostrils.
Damn.
And the same thing happened in Cats.
But even more, I mean,
but
crazier.
Yes, but it's, yes, totally crazier.
Because I think it's, for me, it was honestly the way they looked. That yeah. I did not, especially because in the music, in the actual musical, the live musical, they have this cool makeup,
it
right?
is, yeah.
It is actually pretty cool and impressive, even for that, for how old it is, yeah. right? But in this case, it looked like just like the weirdest video game furries. I did not understand what's happening. yeah. And then, like I said, Jennifer Hudson, beautiful voice, mm-hmm. ridiculous looking.
Yeah.
But my,
I mean, Jennifer Hudson's rendition of Memory is like the most beautiful version of that song I have ever heard.
Agreed.
And a lot of people have sung that song.
Yes,
but she looks so weird.
She really does. And but my favorite though was watching Perry sink more and more into her seat and just trying not to giggle.
Yeah.
That was really fun.
I forgot. I think I said it to you. I hate the C word, the cringe word. I mm-hmm. try not to use it, but
right.
I, like that is exactly what I, but my heart hurt for a lot of the
yes.
A-list talent in this, especially, I mean, Judy Dench was very hard to look at and
yes.
Ian McKellen was breaking my heart.
Okay,
I
but
also
then
felt
when
like,
Ian McKellen okay. started meowing, I clapped.
Yes.
I was like, that was amazing.
Okay, so yeah. for me, I felt like Ian McKellen was the one person who knew what movie
exactly.
he was in.
Exactly, completely.
Everyone
agree.
Else was taking it too seriously, yeah. and Ian McKellen was like, I'm just gonna chew this scenery
yeah.
and be a cat and a queen.
My favorite too was every scene where the cats were the cat people were sharing their love for each other, and they're basically just doing this.
Or like grooming themselves.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, that was fun.
It's definitely
yeah.
a very bizarre thing. And it's hearing you guys describe the makeup in the
yeah,
show.
Right.
That maybe that's what it is. Maybe it's the fact that it looks like people wearing makeup, whereas
yes.
this is a human face and often human hands and human feet, but the rest of them is meant
forget.
To look like a legitimate cat.
Look at that.
I really,
and
I can't
also,
get
the
life
way the
of
tails
me.
Were
yeah,
moving
it was
creepy.
Weird.
I didn't know what was going
but
on.
But I will actually give a little props to the VFX department, because as awkward as that was to see, you know, fleshed out the way that Tom Hooper envisioned it, I mean, they did their job.
Yeah, that's how
that looked
tails.
As I imagine they yeah. intended for it to look.
You know, but why did they design them so creepy?
It is. It's so strange because, again,
they made like, something weirder than Polar Express.
Right. Literally,
yeah.
my friend who I was sitting with turned to me during the tap dance cat train number and goes, this looks like Polar Express.
But creepier.
Yes.
Because I'm terrified of that movie.
Yes.
And this, but except for cats, I'm not terrified. I just could not stop staring. That's the thing. Like, I actually kind of want to go see it with my friends again
totally.
Just to see their reactions. So I think that's the reason it might make money. It's an awesomely bad movie.
So wait, let's take a moment to actually do that. Would you recommend because this is a
yeah.
bizarre review. I've never really had a review conversation like this before. Do you guys recommend that people go out and see Cats?
I think that if you enjoy bad movies like I do, where you just, where you know what you're getting and you're gonna go to the theater and just have a good time and laugh at a movie and laugh with your friends, this is a good movie for you.
I completely concur. This is one of those movies where you go in and you go, I cannot wait for the How Did This Get Made episode about this. And I mean, there is something, like you were saying, Perry, about the experience of shared laughter in the theater. And I guarantee you that's gonna happen if you go see Cats.
Definitely.
So it's a great theater experience, even if it's not a great movie.
That's especially because there's part of the reason why I would recommend
It's so and there's weird so many good actors in it that that's what makes it more bizarre.
And it, you know, I don't wanna knock any of their performances too, because one thing I was very impressed by the whole time is that as ridiculous as all of this was, they were committed.
Oh,
they were giving it their all.
Oh yeah.
But it feels so wrong to recommend a movie when, you know, and I feel bad saying this too, we're laughing at the movie. We're not laughing with the movie. None of this was their intention whatsoever, but I really do think there's value in that. And I think if you want to have a good time with a whole bunch of people, now is the time to see Cats when you can have that shared experience. Cause I don't know if you're going to have the same experience with it sitting at home by yourself, unless maybe you had like one or 20 drinks in your hand or something like that. But this is the kind of movie to me that it's sitting right now at an 18% on Rotten Tomatoes. That is a very, very low score with a review count of 95 reviews. So that's a significant amount already. But this is the kind of poorly reviewed movie that could wind up becoming, you know,
a cultural phenomenon.
Like a midnight movie type classic, where it becomes, you know, a sing-along riot or something like that. So who knows?
Look at what happened with The Room. Right?
Yeah.
With Tommy Wiseau, you never know. If that could do it, why not Cats?
Dude, like, give me sing-along versions of Cats, please.
Yeah. Oh, boy.
Amazing.
Now, I have a question for you, for both of you. After you saw the movie, could you look at your cats in the eye?
It's such a
good question. Because I went home immediately, and my roommate and I were sitting watching, I think we were catching up on Encore on Disney Plus. So like, I went from the musical Cats to a show about people from high school reuniting to do their high school musical again.
That's Emma for you
guys. It's me. I mean, it's the most me statement that's ever existed. And my cat Light comes over to me and I literally asked him, I was like, Light, what's your Jellicle name? You're not gonna tell me?
I kind of want to make a Dewey song or something. Yeah. But it wouldn't be half as interesting as these bizarre stories. Right. And what's the cat's name that's Francesca Hayward's like Victor. Friend cat?
Oh, Mr. Mistopheles?
No. Not the magic. Not like the magician cat.
Oh, Muscus Trap? The narrator guy?
Sure. Yeah.
Sure. I am very impressed.
Dewey looks a little like
he
him.
He does a
so
little
when
bit.
When I got home, I was like, I basically like just stood in the middle of my living room and I stared at Dewey for a little while, just like deep in thought.
and you're like, are you like the Cats movie I just saw?
I don't know.
Are you a Jellicle or are you not? Or should you Jellicle?
I did genuinely start to think that maybe the better route was to go like the super silly CG route with Cats where you just like make their little mouths move instead of having humans play them. But I don't think there's an easy answer to this. Maybe Cats should have just existed on the stage. But then again, I would see it again.
What a time to be alive.